the Agronomist. Today's topic, soybean emergence tips and tricks, is one that was actually hand-selected by Phil. Many of you may not know, but Phil has a master's degree in soybean physiology, so when it comes to soybeans, it's a topic that he really enjoys to talk about, and he has some great tips to share with us all today. So, to lead us off, Phil, a question. Where do we start when we're going out to scout soybeans?
Sure. Yeah, and I don't want to dwell on it, but obviously I did spend a lot of time in my master's degree out in the field. It seems like I get that a lot. They're like, well, you went to a lot of schooling, you know, you probably just read a lot of books. And no, if you do a thesis master's, you spend 90%, 95% of your time in the field and 5% riding for the last 6 months or so. So I spent a lot of time looking at soybeans all season long. And the first thing that we always did, beginning season, end of season, no matter what, and what I would always encourage everybody to do right now is you're going out looking at your soybeans just emerging, maybe they're up a little ways, doesn't matter. The first thing I always do is take a stand count. And I know that's one of those things, it's like, I don't have a tape measure, there's lots of excuses, I guess, for it. I always carry a tape measure, you know, a lot of people do, but if you don't, I'll give you a quick, an easier way to do stand counts with soybeans. Now, this is not something you just should do widespread, because obviously it's a small sample, but if you're looking at 30-inch rows, and a faster way to do it, instead of pulling a tape measure out to 17 feet, 5 inches, is to just pull out to 21 inches. That is 1/10,000th of an acre, and makes it a lot faster. So in 17 feet, 5 inches, you would count 140 plants at 140,000, if you got full stand. At 21 inches, you'll count 14. So a little faster way to do it, and another thing a lot of people do with this is measure out 21 inches and then see how big your shoe is and do a couple, you know how big your shoe size is and how many steps you need to put one in front of another to figure that out. So it's quick, it's just a fast way to do that. I will say it makes a little bit of a challenge for those of you in different spacings, obviously. So any multiple of 30. So 30, you'll look at one row. If you're in 15s, you'll look at two rows. If you're in 10s, you'll look at three, and 7.5s, you'll look at four. Now, if you're in 20s or 22s, it's going to be a little more challenging. So I just helped you out a little bit, divided it out. In 22-inch rows, it's going to be 29 inches of one row. And in 20-inch rows, it's going to be 32 inches. So it's not hard math by any means, but it just makes it a lot faster to get out there and look at things. You know, this time of the year, we're seeing there could be damping off issues, you know, from certain diseases. Phytophthora, obviously, is a threat all season long. But just a lot of things going on out there in the field, you know, looking at emergence, seeing how they're emerging. So that right off the bat gives you a quick count of, okay, we've got 12 plants that emerged. They're all similar growth stage. We've got two that are behind. I took a couple pictures, so we'll see some of those. And obviously, you know, depending on how much residue is out there, a lot of times you do see some that emerge differently. So the first thing you do right off the bat that I always do is take a stand count. And the best part about this is I always reference this closer to harvest, but this really is key to understanding. I get a lot of people ask me about high yield soybeans. Oh, they only planted 60,000 or something like that. Well, this is why you take a stand count early season and then late season, because they typically always record final plant stand. And what that means is what's in the field at harvest. That's really what matters, corn or beans, what's in the field right before you take the combine in there. So if you do this and use something like our Data Forward app that you can track where you were, then you can go back to that spot at the end of the season to make sure it's a similar plant stand. What took the plants away? If you lost plant stand, just kind of opens your eyes, because you'd be surprised that soybeans are very competitive leaf area wise, and they don't always show the same number at the end of the season that you see at the beginning.
Interesting. Okay. So what are some things happening now in the season that we're going through today that are affecting that soybean growth and development?
Sure, yeah. So the first thing, and I took a picture, I know we'll put that up there, but the first thing you want to do after you take the stand count is stage the soybeans. And soybeans, for some reason, are always challenging just because people don't do it enough. It's not a bad thing, it's just they're a little bit challenging. So as soon as they start popping through the ground, and I've got in my picture, I've got a couple examples of pretty much all three. You'll see the one in the middle is just breaking through the ground. So once 50% of them are just breaking through the ground, we call that VE, or vegetative emergence. And then the one just to the right of that, you can see the cotyledons unfolding. that would be still VE. So we actually don't call it VC or vegetative cotyledons until we see the unifoliates expanded. So that would be the picture on the left side with the little unifoliate leaves pretty much expanded, and they'll eventually get out side by side. So one important thing to note on that I always tell people is they typically get confused on leaf stages with soybeans. V1, like we talk about corn a lot of times with the leaf collar method, V1 in a soybean is when you see that first trifoliate, so three leaves, just like alfalfa, you see that first three-leafed leaflet there on the plant. So when you're seeing the unifoliates, those one leaf on each side, that is not V1, that's VC, vegetative cotyledon. It's just confusing because you see unifoliates and you're still calling it the cotyledons, which were the first leaves out of the ground. So it just seems a little bit backwards, but that's how they stage them. So when you see that first trifoliate leaf come out, that's going to be V1 in the soybean plant. So some things to think about at this point, you know, just breaking through the ground. Obviously, there's a lot of things that can come up, issues typically. This is one thing, this stage, even you see all three of those is a good stage. A lot of times we see damage from authority products, sulfentrazone and so forth. Splashing up, heavy rains and so forth. It's really easy. They're close to the ground, so they can get that herbicide splashed onto them. It's a PPO, so it's going to burn them a little bit. So a lot of times we see that around that growth stage. The other thing I want to point out with these, it's kind of apparent in the picture, is the color. And I tell people this a lot, whether they're looking at corn or beans, but knowing and understanding the color is important to the plant. So you see a nice green color, and then you see purple. So once it breaks that plane of the soil line, you're gonna start to see a purple stem. That's not a bad thing, that's completely normal. And then under the soil line, you should see white. So white is typically healthy, especially inside of a stem. But as they pop up out of the ground, you'll see that purple color coming up to the first leaves, I won't call them true leaves, but the cotyledons showing up there. And then a lot of times if you've had something like Ilevo, you'll see that, you know, that halo or something on those the cotyledons, you know, so you can potentially see some of that damage there. But another thing I want to point out that gets overlooked a lot, and I see this a lot in fields, depending what you're planting with, your planter type and so forth, you can see uneven emergence. As you can see, these were pulled out of the same row. I'm not hand picking them here. These were a little uneven in terms of not necessarily planting depth, but some residue issues out in the field. And this is a great example, the one in the middle, of showing what's called a swollen hypocotyl. This happens quite a bit. Typically, it's related to crusting. So, and I'm not trying to be mean, this is where I get my love-hate relationship for rollers, land rollers. They do this a lot. Any crust that's formed on the top of the soil surface requires a huge amount of force to push through and break up that soil surface. So if you're in 30-inch rows, you have plants spaced, you know, really close together. So they have a lot more force going up. If you're in 15s or wider, your plants are not as close together. So they don't have that force, because a lot of times you can walk out in the field and you can see that crack all the way down a 30-inch row. That's because there was a pretty hard crust and they broke it together. And a lot of times you'll see something like that swollen hypocotyl. And what that means is it was trying to push for a long time. In this case, it was pushing on residue, corn stalk that was below the ground, pushing up and couldn't do it. This one did make it, obviously. Sometimes they don't, but this one did make it. But that swollen hypocotyl being that much thicker there compared to the other two plants means that it struggled. That's why it's set back a ways. So that's a good thing to look for early season. I always try to, you know, find out why maybe they're emerging unevenly. At this point in the staging game, it's still acceptable, you know, to replant. Once you get VC to V1, it typically doesn't, especially if you're planting beside the row, it's not gonna pay you to replant. Those beans are gonna outcompete, and the later ones you planted will not typically yield anything. They just don't have enough room. The other ones will make up for the distance and the room and branch out and things like that. So yeah, just some things to think about. That's a great picture to kind of reference and understand, you know, grow stage wise, but also some of the challenges coming out of the ground that soybeans struggle with. They visually can show it, obviously, if you look hard enough.
Okay. So another question then, what are some things specifically that we should look for this season as we continue to progress in emergence and growth?
Sure, yeah. You know, the one thing I didn't mention on that is soybeans. I always talk about how forgiving to some extent they are. They're amazing little plants, just like corn. They may not yield as much, but obviously, if you want to bring that argument, I have things in my back pocket with that one too. But it's another topic. So, but the cool thing about small little soybean plants is those cotyledons actually power that plant for 7 to 10 days once it's up out of the ground. And many times this comes into the question, the hail issue. If you get hail, strip those cotyledons off, there's the plant dead. The growing point is inside those two cotyledons down in the stem, so it's still protected. A lot of times it doesn't kill the plant, but that's the main, those cotyledons, those little seed leaves, are the main source, excuse me, of energy for that plant. So if you strip them off, you can see typically anywhere from 2 to 7 to 10% yield loss just from that, which is amazing to me because it shows how much that it struggles at that point. You could strip all the leaves off a soybean plant when it's starting to flower, and it'll only lose 10 to 15% yield because there's a lot already built there. The nodes are there. You have a lot. You just need the leaves back, essentially. And this kind of shows why some people choose to do things like cobra, you know, or why hail, when hail hits, sometimes we see a stronger yield if it's at a certain growth stage because soybeans can branch out. They can make up for it and come back really strong if they have late season rain. So I did want to make a little quick comparison, just a nice little thing to leave everybody with, because we always talk about corn and the importance of early season with corn. Well, soybeans, obviously, they make up later in the season, typically yield, you know, like I said, if they get rains and stuff in that August, that grain fill, pod fill time period, they usually do okay. But it's still important early season to understand how they operate. So in a corn plant around V5, so I'm going to make a reference to V5, so 5 trifoliates, which won't take much time once we get going, get out of this cool weather and so forth. You know, it only takes 3 to 5 days to add another trifoliate, so it'll come quick. But so if we're looking at V5 soybeans compared to V5 corn, when you're out scouting and looking at them, V5 corn plant, we always talk about that growing point is just starting to move above ground, and that's also shortly after that. V5, V6 is typically when the ear is developed and the girth on that ear, V5 to V7. And then V6 is also when most of those leaves are initiated in a corn plant. So if you look at a soybean plant on the other side, V5 is typically the time when most of those nodes are established. So I always talk about that, you know, early planting helps with this. It's not king. And in a lot of cases when we see cool temperatures like this, it can actually kind of flip-flop. Soybeans require GDUs just like corn does. This is a common misconception. A lot of times I get that, oh, they're so photo period, you know, day length sensitive. Actually, it's night length. If you want to turn on a night light on your soybean field, you know, just throughout the night, even for a minute, it will screw it up and they will not flower. But it's actually early season when they're going through these early vegetative stages is more crucial to have heat and GDUs than it is to, you know, meet that summer solstice, essentially. So if we have a lot of heat early season, we can see flowering, you know, right about or before that summer solstice, even in our climate and so forth. So if we don't, in a year like this where it seems like it's staying cool, it's probably going to be into July before we see them start to flower. So once they start to flower, then they do, those stages really start to change based on day length. So yeah, it's kind of a fascinating plant, a lot of little things to know about them. So.
All right, interesting. You can definitely see the passion for soybeans coming out until today, so great topic. Is there anything else you want to leave our listeners with today?
No, I think the biggest takeaway is 21 inches. Just remember that. It's simple and easy, and just pay attention to how healthy they are in the field, because that's still going to determine what they do later on in the season. So.
All right, great. Well, thanks, Phil. Thanks, viewers, for tuning in. If you have other questions about soybeans or soybean emergence, you can always visit the field position. We've got several resources there from our experts like Phil. Or shoot us a message on social media. That's where we gather our topics for our weekly Ask the Agronomist episodes. We'd love to field some questions to help you with a great soybean crop this year. So see you next week.